just really cool, and just show of love from everybody in this room, everybody up here, everybody up there. Really, truly amazing. Not really my fault, but in over 30 years ago, I went to go see a band by the name of Bitch at a club in Orange County, California. And one of the bands opening for them was this band called Slagel. And I got to the club, and I got there early enough to see them. And because I always like to check out what bands were happening before the main band came on. And the name was pretty cool. So I was standing there, and they went on stage, and my jaw literally just dropped open.
Fuck
they
yeah.
They played mostly cover tunes at that point. And there's a couple of originals. But what they were doing on stage, what those four guys were doing up on stage, was something really amazing to me. I felt something just click in my head, like, wow, this is really cool. And so I went backstage afterwards and talked to the guy who was their manager, and Jeff and Carrie and a couple of guys. I think I might have talked to the man. I don't know. Long time ago. Anyway, said I had this compilation album and love to have them on. And this, that, and the other thing happened, and we ended up having them on the compilation and doing a record with them as well. First record, of course, we did was Showdovers.
Fuck yeah! Fucking tormentor!
One of the amazing things about being in the studio for that was watching Jeff. Jeff was really a young kid, very shy, didn't say a whole lot. But in the studio, he was just playing unbelievable stuff. I mean, all four of those guys were playing unbelievable stuff.
Fuck yeah.
And I remember one night, like, Jeff had done a bunch of guitar work. Sounded really good. And, you know, he left, and I looked at Bill Matore, who was here, the engineer. And I would just kind of looked at each other and shook our heads like, wow, that was really amazing. Such an unbelievable player. You know, really, back then, you had a feeling that something special was happening when we were making that record, but I don't think any of us, certainly I didn't realize how special that would really become. Again, just so amazing. It went on to, you know, Hello Waits, we did as well. On in the Chapel as well. We did.
Look, Chemical Warfare!
And it was just...
Chemical Warfare!
And watch them play and see Jeff, you know, writing this unbelievable metal stuff. And really, when you sit back and look at all the stuff he wrote, not only, you know, all the way up through his career, just amazing stuff. I mean, some of the stuff really changed the course in the history of metal. I don't know if people really, you know, take a step back and really look at the songs in the room. It's a pretty impressive amount of stuff that he did. Really amazing.
No doubt.
Awesome. So, you know, Jeff as a person, too, was a really good guy. As Nick mentioned, he was a little shy, but he did like to have a couple of drinks. He was also a huge sports fan. As you know from him wearing his Raiders gear all the time on stage. Cheer for the Raiders, right? So we talk a lot about the Raiders. Also talk a lot with Carrie about the Raiders as well. Unfortunately, they didn't do so well some of the time, but they did well a lot of the time. So, Jeff also became a big hockey fan, too. Big LA Kings fan. I was really lucky, as the Kings were going to the Stanley Cup last year, I was really lucky to be able to get Jeff some tickets. He called me up and said, hey, do you think there's any way you can give me a couple of playoff tickets? I said, yeah, let me see what I can do. So I was able to pull a couple of strings and got him some playoff tickets. And he was super happy, and we were talking about the games. I think they won both games he went to at that point. He was super happy. So then the Kings, by some miracle, and those of us who are Kings fans realize that this is a miracle, they went all the way to the Stanley Cup Finals. Never in our lifetime would any of us imagine that was there. So Jeff called me one day and said, hey, you got me those playoff tickets. You think you gave me Stanley Cup final tickets? But, well, let me see what I can do. And I actually, as luck would have it, a friend of mine who works